Welcome to the Shortwave Radio Channel, and just to mention a quick change that is going to arrive at the end of this month. We are at the last few weeks of the winter schedules. Schedules change twice a year, and this is because of the changing propagation aspect of the ionosphere, depending on the season. The schedules are set to change the last Sunday of the month of March, which is going to be March the 28th. And that will mean we'll be at the A21 schedule season when that happens. Right now we're at the B20, which is the second or winter schedules of the year 2020 that extends partly into the new year. I will share once again this web page where I often like to go. It's the most accurate list of schedules. EIBIspace.de. You have a list by time on the left, by frequency on the right. It's not, I will admit, super user friendly, but when you start using it, you get used to it at some point. Remember that the way that it's divided is, time of the broadcast in UTC, the station's location, the station name, the language, the target area, and the frequencies with the transmitter sites. So that means that, for example, if I look at anyone here, let's look at this one here, 00 to 030, Thailand, Radio Thailand, in English, Eastern North America is ENA, so that's the target area and the frequency that is used. And the letter is for the transmitter site, which in this case is Udorn, Thailand. When there is a slash and a names, often it's because there's a relay of that broadcast from a certain area. Another example here is, let's go down. Let's say that I want to check what's the schedules. Here it goes. We 01 to 01, 0200, for example. I would look here. What would this mean? Well, that would mean 01 to 0200 UT, CUB, which is the ITU short name for Cuba, or abbreviation, Radio Vani Cuba. Then you have S, which is Spanish, AM for America, and the transmitter, the frequency and transmitter site in Cuba, 11760. CAM Central America, CAR Caribbean, SAM South America, EU is Europe. Remember that on the page, to get acquainted with these abbreviations, you have a README text that gives you abbreviations, transmitter codes, and all. I know it's not the easiest list to use, but it is the most accurate of all. So this is the good thing about the EIBI space list. And you have all the transmissions, 24-hour of transmissions of different stations, and slowly get acquainted with it. I think it's worth to take the time. There are easier websites that you can use also, like shortwave.info, but they often are a little outdated and a lot of information isn't there. Also, make sure that your frequency that you tuned is accurate and so on. And of course, the frequency list is what I use when I want to know what I'm listening to. So it'll be, for example, checking out, oh, there's something in English on 15770 at 21 UT. What could it be? Well, I'll type in the search 15770, and oh, look at that, 21 to 2130, Radio Prague. It gives you an example immediately of what could be on the air. I'll post the link to that schedule page in the description below, and remember that in the next few weeks we will be changing the schedules for summer. So changes means that a lot of the stations you might be listening to right now will have different frequencies for the summertime. If you enjoy our videos, please subscribe, give us thumbs up. Thank you for watching.